Hey guys, Diesel here. Doing another farming sim video. We're back on Madison Creek. As you can see, I'm just now warming up my cow tractor. As you can see, it's 8 o'clock in the morning, so it's just kind of need to get it warmed up a little bit. But got a lot to do today. It has been about 2 days since in-game days since last video. I was wanting to kind of take care of the cows first before we get into anything else. So come in here, go drink my manure in the bucket. Ground tip has gone up 2 degrees though since I was planting. But yeah, it's been about 2 days since we started planting in the last video. So not in real life, of course. When I say like 2 days or whatnot, that's when I say it. I mean in game days. And so, oh Lord, I may have to go a little. They don't need no silage, so we'll take it from here. They're still getting water. So they're topped off in water. Just bring this over here. This is what I do with all the extra silage and everything that I end up getting from that. So. I do plan on getting to putting manure in. Trailer right here at some point. Right now that's on the back burner. I don't know how. Yeah, I got some in there. I knew I had some in there, I didn't know how much. But what we're going to do is we're going to give the cows straw. So what we're going to do is we're going to turn around. Well, trying to do a bigger turn. This time we're starting off with being up here at the cows. Didn't really show much of it in the last video, but we got one field of corn left. I will show you guys while we're loading up the straw. Got it, the multi-felling thing here. Since we haven't harvested any crops yet, it's not like, oh, shoot.
Cutting it.
But yeah, since we don't have no, since we haven't really harvested anything and whatnot, I always get the straw and stuff out of here. Heritage Grand Express. I'm sorry, I'm just looking at something. My brain just kind of like, eh? So, you get to see all the equipment we got. look at all that. It's a lot of stuff. A lot of stuff. Yeah, we're going to get rid of that. Because I want to see... Yeah, that took away that. Okay, that's the what I've just bought stuff out of. Okay, there we go. Milk. Huh, okay. So, Ardo milk. Oh wow. Okay. I might do that. We might do that right at the end of the video, after we get some markers going on planting soybeans. Because that's what the main thing we're going to focus on today, other than finishing up that last field of corn planting. We are going to be finishing up that last field, and so we'll be driving the Magnum for that. Because it is 25 right down here, right across the road from us. And then, once we get done with that field, then we'll go down to the farm and get some stuff ready for soybean planting. These two are done. Alright, we need this truck right here. Look at the corn! Hey! Very, very nice. I need to check one thing, though. Okay, good. Okay. And yes, we do not have wheat done. Alright. This tractor will be taken over to the 37. That's where we're heading to right now. That's the only thing about it is, you know, you have to plant the crops at different times and stuff like that. Like, you plant corn before soybeans, so the corn grows before the soybeans. Just wait and see how things go, I guess. We get to check out another field, too. That field up there looks like, yep, got corn, little corn. I still gotta get my liquid fertilizer trailer from over here. Still gotta get it. Take it back over to the farm. I'm gonna have to have all of my equipment serviced soon. Basically, we'll touch up on the paint and whatnot. So, we actually get to use this big old girl today. Part of the Vulgar and DLC. Haven't got to properly use it in the video yet. So, today's the day. I may get one of the 9Rs out in the field as well. Try to help get everything planted faster a little bit. That's the only thing I don't like about stuff like this, is it kind of pushes the equipment whenever you like turn and whatnot. You're not careful. But yeah, so we'll be getting to use that for our first time. But of course, I've used this quad track a bit, as you can tell. All my case equipment have been used a lot more than the John Deere, of course, but I had to actually, even though I'm trying to stay realistic, I had to actually fix the way some of these are on ours, because I've been playing on this map for a while, and so some of them I've changed equipment and everything left and right, so some of these I wanted to fix where I felt comfortable with having ours. But also too, I kind of come across some used tractors for sale across the map. So we'll go and check them out. Against the rail, but
I hate having to use this.
Because I can't use it because it's full of seed. Oh my lord, Jesus. Alright, let's do this. Do that. See, I can move this freely.
So weird.
It's annoying. But anyways, Yeah, they went and did some driving with brand new quad tracks and new Steiger. And it has the AFS connect to it, which is cool. And the way the cab looks and the newer quad tracks and stuff like that is, oh my lord. It puts this cab to shame, honestly. Oh, no!
Why?
See what I'm talking about? It's annoying. Oh. Giants, make it right, dang it. I'm tired of this. This is horse crap. But anyways. Yeah, my words are still going strong. Let me get you hooked up. That's another thing too, is whenever you have these parked, do not have it disconnected, like the drill disconnected from the seeder. For some reason, do don't understand why. But so yeah, kind of annoying. And also too, I'm gonna let you guys know. I'm gonna update y'all. When I was talking about Midwest Horizons, I don't really. I kind of went ahead and deleted the save and everything like that, so Midwest Horizons is done. I don't know if any of y'all or deal with that or whatnot, but I went through my mods and was getting rid of a lot of mods, a lot of the foreign maps, getting kind of rid of and the foreign stuff, trying to just keep it, you know, Americanized. I think I still got Greenwich Valley, I'm not sure. Still kind of debating on continuing that. This one. Here's 19RX. Which one do we want to run? All my equipment's got a lot of hours. The least amount of hours, I do believe, on main tractor wise and stuff is 29 or 30 hours. Max I got on any of my harvester tractors is like 50-something, 51, 52, something like that. We'll get this one crippled. So, we're going to go get it hooked up to a seeder. Kind of try to alternate tractors around and stuff. Get off. I hate this lag too. I wish the Giants would fix that crap. Because it shouldn't matter how much equipment you got, it shouldn't lag a computer down so bad. Rather it's equipment or grain bins or amount of grain you got stored in the bins or whatnot, it should not matter. Oh, and I figured out what I'm going to do with Field 43, since this is a very tiny field, and you guys can remember I'll show you Field 43. I'm actually going to use it for chaff. We are going to have it as one of the chaff fields. I can't remember, I think I showed you guys the little bit of where I'm going to do silage and stuff like that. I did really want to see if you guys in the last video. Not much. Oh Lord, this controller does not stop the work of the computer. It's really irritating. Show you guys two tractors I bought. They have a pretty good amount of power. One of them you can see because there was only made in soybean. The other one is fairly new, but I don't have as much hours. Actually, no, there's two. So I noticed there's one. One tractor up there next to the store at the Chula place. Definitely whenever we take the milk, hopefully we can take the milk and leave the video. We'll probably actually go and do that after we get this tractor set up. Since 37 to 46 will take the longest. Try to get the tractor back to the farm, preferably tonight, or maybe tomorrow if I'm not too tired. Now we are doing a drive up here. But yeah, before we come into day 9, everything over here, except for like I said, 25 planting, you know, it got late and I had to not sleep for a month. Excuse me. But I'm kind of glad that we were able to finally get soybeans planted and seeding going on. I'm very, very pleased with that. That's the last crop we got to get. Selected. I am going to look at the map real quick. Cold chill. Sorry. Yeah, see, we still have a decent amount to do in that field. Wow. All those went through a fast stage of growth last night. There's only some of these here that was already green the previous day. But, yeah. So there's soybeans getting done. So we'll get this one going here now. So lower that. I'd rather use the seeders for soybeans than use the planters for corn only. Unless I absolutely need to use the planters for soybeans. So, but yeah, there he goes. So what we're going to do now is we're going to actually get in this truck here, detach this trailer, open the gate. Open gate. Thank you. Cows escaping. We don't want to hear about the calls of a cow. We actually got a couple of maneuver spreaders over there that we're going to use next season. Next spring will be a lot more work than this. This one. Because of the fact that able to actually market some green. That's why we got so much money. I haven't sold the green yet. I actually taken the green to the thing yet, but we've marketed enough that they've already given us a check. So I think it was a check of about $400,000 for a million liters. Yeah, about 30,000 bushels of wheat. So that's roughly about how much we've got marketed right now. We got to haul out, so that's going to be a lot of hauling. So I'll probably do that off screen. And they said they're not really in a hurry for it, but so we could slowly do that over time. They know right now we're getting prepped for the plant, you know, for growing season and everything like that. So. But yeah, two to three tractors I actually bought from the farmer up here. He's actually still got them sitting on the side of the road, but he took them for sale right now. So we're going to have a look at them. I don't think these fields will take as long as the planting corn did. So that field was corn last year. I think they're leaving that there this year. I'll plant nothing. Just leave it. Should have gone quick with fields before we start seeing that. But I have thought about buying this land over here. I know I could buy it. stop on the way back, but that's the two tractors. But yeah, I want to get the sold and start heading back before we stop and look at them. If I was to move, I'd be losing one of the biggest fields in this area. So I just don't want to lose that field coming as well. And I will say this, it didn't take as long as I thought it would to plant corn in that field, considering how big that field was. So I think we tractor is probably one of a lot of money we have. But But surprisingly around here, the only old timing tractor I can find is a Case tractor. Thing is, if I was to keep it on where I could select, you know, drive the train, it would actually go out of the map. See, this train's longer than what was in, like, the standard Giants map, so yeah, that's why it kind of has that little hiccup where it goes up a little bit and back down. So, very, very long. But yeah, it does go off the map. That's the only annoying thing about the train on this map. You know, you can drive it. First time I've been out here, honestly. I've not driven out here before. So it kind of gets really good. That's a good little problem, though. I think most of the farmers this year are from east around here. I do want to get a setup for the ammonia, the hydrous ammonia stuff. For seed, lime, fertilizer. Maybe we go in here and sell it? Thank you. I honestly do not know where it's at all. That's bales.
I thought it was, but I pulled up to it.
Guys obviously said they didn't start transferring milk to us. So I was like, struggle with trying to sell milk. should pop one of those in, press RV Prime, so that's if we get this thing to back up. probably try to work on this later tonight or tomorrow, whichever, whenever I do my bit. Like I said, I got a long work week weekend. Like I said, in my previous video, I said, probably end up having to look up the video for it. What we're gonna do is just gonna leave out there, and then I'm gonna go and show you guys. I'm gonna see if. Yeah. So these are the two that I bought from Myth Farmer. One is a New Holland T9565 Smart Tracks. I do believe it's what it is. I know it's Road Crop Tracks, but I'm not sure if it's Smart Tracks or not that New Holland has. Now, for most of y'all that didn't know, this will probably be our next brand to come to the farm, anyways, because New Holland is owned by Case IH. Even though the parent company of Case IH and New Holland is Fiat, but back in the day, New Holland was actually had been bought by Case IH. So, and then we got our 747 Big Bud. There's actually a pretty good price on it, compared to what it, you know, with it being in good shape as it is. Let's see. It's got 15,000 hours. And of course, you gotta remember this tractor was made in the 70s, 80s, something like that. So, I paid about $150, I think it was $200,000 for that. So, this one here's got 5,000 hours. Yeah, 5,002 hours. So, and it's a relatively new tractor, so I actually did take out a loan for getting all three tractors, because, of course, this one here, with it being as big of a tractor as it is, you know, it wasn't going to go cheaply. but since I seen it was up for sale, couldn't help resist not getting it. And along with this one, with it, I mean, I think one of these run about 400, 500,000. Only paid like, I think it's 250 as well. I think that's 200,000 for it to have 5,000 hours on it. So it's not bad. Not too bad. The other one was a really was a steal though, because it's an older model tractor than this one, and I think it's early '70s. I'm not sure. I can't remember when it was made. I might be wrong. Y'all going to slash me on it, but let's go look at it, shall we? And what we'll do is actually we'll just go fast travel over here. Oh, here we are. This is another place too. I could take the cell, the milk, but I don't know where that cell is. But here's the other tractor I bought. It is the 8970 John Deere. I'm not sure the exact year for this, so I know you guys are probably going to slam me on the year years I said earlier. This is custom moddings, just so you guys know. But yeah, she's seen better days. I have to get a coat of paint put on her. I don't know how many hours. Oh. Drive us back to the farm and park it up in front of the shop and we'll call it a day. So, I know it's a little longer than the other video, but That happens from time to time. But yeah, as you can see, corn is growing really good over there in the field. But yeah, basically everything on every field on the right hand side of the road will be used for chaff. Everything else from here over and up will be used for corn. We'll end up working on this with first coat of John Deere green paint on it, get cows, everything like that. Get it buttoned up really good. And we'll try using this out in the field hopefully this fall. It doesn't have a PTO on it, so I can't use it for the grain cart. So that's out in the picture of the grain cart. That's the way my 600 bud is, the 600 bud we have. That one doesn't have a PTO, so I can't use it, but like the other way it seems. And the same way with the 747 bud. I do know the big buds do not have PTOs on them, so. So I'm just gonna pull this right here and park it. So yeah, that's our new purchases, equipment-wise. I'm trying to debate on certain other equipment to kind of sell, so maybe selling them, getting a little money, more of my extra money. But like I said, we do have some wheat contracted. We'll just slowly contract that out over the year. So as you can see, should take us down to about 1.2 mil. So we have a whole lot of trucking to do eventually. So, but yeah, we're gonna leave it here, guys. So we got a lot of work done. We've got almost all of our corn planted, except for over here. I'll finish this up off screen. I don't know about tonight. Oh yeah, I forgot about that little bit right there. Oh well, they ain't gonna really hurt nothing. But oh, why you stopped? Mofle. Thank you. Ah, okay. Okay. You guys will watch me do this. So, but whenever it gets to a situation like this, we've got to do it like this, so that way we can. And we just unfold it again. Because the pressure of folding that out or folding that up will push the cart back. But anyway, so you guys are going to be able to watch me end this off with us planting soybeans. So I'll leave it here, guys. And until next time, happy farming.